is granted and are not dead. And certainly the memory of our late brothers and sisters shall always abide within us who know them so well. I posthumously extend my gratitude to those loyal, devoted members of the fraternity. In the broad stream of birth, of life, and death, there is an unbroken line. The chosen few, those who by deeds, their lives, their character, set the standard of human excellence for the rest of us to follow. In this group belong our late brothers and sisters. I know each of you join me in the admiration and respect for our late brothers and sisters who have done so much for our fraternity and have won the affection of our members. At this moment, we pause with profound reverence to pay tribute to our brothers and sisters now departed. They were loyal and devoted members. Now they slumber peacefully, free from care and pain. They knew that to enjoy the blessings of liberty, equality, and fraternity, they had to meet responsibilities which they did so well. While there is sadness in them, there is joy in memory of this grand memorial service. We happily remember our dear brothers and sisters who defended the principles of our great order. We shall always remember them. Thank you so much. May I ask Illustrious Sister Bernardita Guiman to come and give us the eulogy.
Chairman, Board of Directors, whose vision for exciting projects was initiated, followed by Lucius Brother Venancio Ibarra, Grand Prosecutor, who placed a fraternity on draft when it came to state guidelines and the updating of the Constitution and bylaws of the Leonarios de Trabajo in America Incorporated. Illustrious Brother Frank Lasatin, Worshipful Master, Worshipful Yulikalats number 6 of 8, who worked hard to keep his lives in existence, an old model of a pure Leonario in action and in deed. Hardworking sister, Illustrious Sister Pauline Gorospe, immediate past Grand Secretary. Illustrious Sister Ruth Navarro, Grand Treasurer, energetic and full of wisdom, a pillar of the fraternity, who loved to call the Grand Lads her second home. They are joined by dedicated, kind, compassionate, helpful, talented, and loving Leonarios who served the different lads and fraternity officers and committees with a burning desire to share their time and skill. As Leonarios, we are gathered here with the grieving family, relatives, and friends in the presence of the Almighty God to pay tribute to our beloved brothers and sisters. It is our humble way of showing our love and respect. During the time when they were still with us, our beloved brothers and sisters used the 24 hours of the day accordingly. 8 hours for labor, 8 hours for study and recreation, and 8 hours for rest. Before resting from their labors, each one of them gave their best to God, country, family, and community. I cannot find the right words to describe their loyalty to their fraternity. They were serious and answerable to God when they took their oath to protect and uphold the Constitution and bylaws of the Leonarios de Trabajo in America. Being true Leonarios, they share their joys and sorrows, and they made you feel very special and loved. It is a very precious feeling, worthy to be followed. The work and duty of our dear brothers and sisters on earth are now finished, as God had called them to join Him in heaven, for their works were pleasing to God. We are grateful for their great contributions to their lives and to their fraternity, as well as to God, country, and family. As we mourn the loss of our beloved brothers and sisters, let us cherish the virtues and principles of life and the sweet memories they left to us. I'll not forget when we met in the parking lot last March 11 of this year. Sister Navarro, with her signature smile, surprised me with her greeting, "Happy birthday, sister." She knew how hard it is for me not to have it with my caring husband, Illustrious Brother Narciva, the Grand Auditor. Illustrious Sister Navarro would not get tired encouraging me for strength. It is hard to think that we are not going to get to see them anymore. While we miss them here, we know that they are now in a better place, looking down at all of us and smiling over us as we pay respect and honor them. There will never be another like them. We remember them. In the rising of the sun and its going down, we remember them. In the bowing of the wind and the chill of winter, we remember them. opening of the buds and the birth of spring, we remember them. In the blueness of the skies and the warmth of summer, we remember them. In the rustling of the leaves and the beauty of autumn, we remember them. In the beginning of the year and when it ends, we remember them. When we are weary and in need of strength, we remember them. When we are lost and sick of heart, we remember them. When we have joys and spacious celebrations we yearn to share, we remember them. So long as we live, they too shall live, for they are part of us. We remember them. May you rest in peace.